Hello and welcome you once again in my new session of geography. As in my last two volume, I have studied about the water bodies. Water bodies? Water bodies are oceans, seas, gulfs, bays, rivers, lakes, ponds, and in some form of snow and ice. Then I've told you about the oceans. The Pacific Ocean is the largest ocean in this world. Then we have studied about the Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, the Arctic Ocean, the Southern Ocean, and what are the importance of the oceans, as oceans provide us a large amount of fresh water through evaporation, how we evaporate the then heat, how it from the evaporation we get the rain, and later on we get the fresh water. Then they have a moderating influence on the climate of the coastal region. They are very much helpful in the transportation of bulky goods at very low costs. Then we have learned about the sea, water sea. It's a saline water. The various seas are Arabian Sea, Bering Sea, Caribbean Sea, the North Sea, Aral Sea, Dead Sea, and Black Sea. After that, the next water bodies was lake like Baikal, Onega, Titicaca, Victoria, Chilica, and Great Lakes of North America. These are all the lakes. And what are lakes? The depression which filled with water are called lakes, or you can say it ponds. They are also useful to generate the electricity. Rivers, water rivers. The types of rivers: upper course, middle course, and the lower course. So now today we are starting with the importance of rivers. First, river provide fresh water for domestic use, industries, and for irrigating the farmland. So river provides us fresh water, especially for the domestic use like cleaning, washing, drinking, and also used in industries and very much needed in a farmland. So rivers provides water for domestic purpose, for industrial purpose, and for irrigation purpose. Then river can form rich and fertile farmland by depositing alluvium or alluvial soil on it. Rivers deposit alluvium in the plain lands, and this alluvium soil are very much rich for irrigation and for fertile. Rivers are mostly navigable in their middle and lower courses. So middle and lower courses are, middle courses begins when the river leaves the hilly area. That means when rivers are leaving the hilly area and enters into the plain, there that are known as middle course. The lower course, as the river approaches towards the sea, and the middle part starts from the plain lands, and when they are entering to the when they are entering into the sea, it is known as a lower course. So that is very much helpful in the navigable. Rivers in the upper course provide suitable sites for the construction of dam to generate electricity. So upper course means hilly area, and there the water of the rivers are helpful to construction of dam and also to generate hydroelectricity. As in the history you have learned about the civilization. So most of the civilization like Indus Valley civilization, Chinese civilization, Egyptian civilization, Mesopotamian civilization, they all cradled or established themselves in the banks of rivers. So the rivers like Indus, the Nile, the Tigris and the Euphrates, these are the rivers where cradles of civilizations like Indus Valley, the Mesopotamian, the Chinese and the Egyptian civilization. In many parts of the world, river acts as an international boundary between the countries. Now there are some causes of the pollution of the water bodies. As you know that nowadays all of us, our rivers got polluted. But why they are polluted? What are the reason of polluting the rivers? Actually, the water is primarily a natural resource essential for the existence of all forms of life on the earth. Water is available in abundance on the earth. Out of this huge amount of water, the amount of fresh water is extremely small. Over the years, many of our water resources have become highly polluted. Water pollution. Water pollution may be defined as the presence of undesirable substances in water like organic, inorganic, biological or radioactive, which can make it unsuitable and harmful for use of human beings, animals, plants, agriculture and industries. See here. This is pollution, water pollution, which are coming from the industrial waste. So water pollution, actually the pollution of fresh water resources is one of the most serious environmental problems before the world today. Today's one of the main problem is the pollution of fresh water resources, pollution in the rivers, pollution in the oceans, pollution in the seas. It is threatening to our life. The main source of water pollution are mentioned as under. First problem is the major source of water pollution is domestic sewage and garbage from the urban and the rural area, discharge directly into the nearby water bodies like rivers, lakes, ponds, etc. without any proper treatment. All of us are polluting our rivers, our lakes, our ponds because we discharged directly the garbage and our domestic sewage into the rivers, into the lakes or into the ponds. Second, most of the industries use a large amount of water at different stages of processing the production. The water discharged from the factories have organic and inorganic chemicals, which when mixed with the river water or any other fresh water form such as lakes or ponds can cause pollution of water. Second threatening is that most of the industries, they use water, and in every processing they are using the water while they are manufacturing or production the good. And in each stage, they are using an organic or inorganic chemicals. And that water is being discharged from the factory directly to the fresh water, and that fresh water is now polluted and it causes harm to the human and to the fish or any other animals, water animals, or anyone who are using those river waters or ponds water. Then the third is the regular use of fertilizers and pesticides by the farmer to grow crops also pollute water. These get washed off by rain into the water bodies. These harmful chemicals can also seep into the ground and pollute the groundwater. As you know that nowadays farmers are using lots of fertilizers and pesticides, and they are using it regular basis. When the rain comes, they wash that fertilizers and pesticides along with themselves, and again it seep into the ground. And when it reach into the groundwater became polluted, as the pesticides are made up of chemicals. In rural areas, most of the people defecate in open areas. In the absence of proper sanitation facilities, the rain can wash off the excreta and animal dung. These can easily mix with the water resources and pollute them. Especially in the rural areas, still people are not using proper washroom, proper toilet. So they don't have any proper sanitation facilities. When rain comes, it wash off their excreta and also the animal dungs, which easily mix up in the water resources, their ponds, their river, and they pollute them. The thermal power plant and oil refineries discharge hot water into the nearby rivers, lake or seas. In the thermal power plants, when the water, they have discharging the hot water, and that hot water mix up in the nearby rivers, lakes or seas. The rise in temperature of the water due to this reason can harm the marine life such as fishes. When this hot water is mixed up in the rivers, lakes or seas, the temperature of the water goes up, and the marine life like fishes can die easily, or it can harm those fishes also. Dumping of radioactive waste in water are also cause its pollution. Crude mineral oil is widely transported in a tanker across the oceans. There is a great possibility of oil spills from the tankers due to the leakage or accident. This can damage the marine ecosystem and pollute the water bodies. As you know that mineral oils are transported in a tanker through the oceans, and there has a great chances of spilling the oil from the tankers. And when it spill in the water, it damages the ecosystem, marine ecosystem, that they died the water and it polluted the water bodies, and most of the fishes or any other marine ecosystem got damaged when oil are spills. See here, there is one picture how the oil spills there. Clear? The natural source of water pollution can be landslide, soil erosion, material coming out of the volcanoes during eruptions and decay of plants and dead animals. These are natural source of water pollution, and they are landslides, soil erosion, some materials when come out from the volcanoes during the eruptions, and decay of plants or dead animals. By carelessly polluting water, we are making it difficult for water to support all forms of life on the earth. Millions of people die every year after consuming polluted water. It seems that by polluting the water resources of the earth, we are harming our own planet. To solve the problem of the water pollution, we should first understand it properly and then become a part of its solution. So we should be educated to solve the problem, how to control the irregularity or to damage the river water, sea water. We should not pollute the sea water, river water, or any other fresh water. Because of the pollution, millions of people are dying every year. So that's all for this session, and I hope that you have understand all the topics about the water bodies. See you in the next session. Till then, have a nice day.